not so little anymore. I've heard all about your big adventure. Look at you, all grown up. I hope he wasn't too much of a bother, Gemma dear.
Of course not. Quite the opposite, in fact. You would have been proud of him. We got attacked by a monster at the top of the tour, and I ended up hanging onto the edge of the cliff. But you'll never guess what happened next. That mark on his hand suddenly lit up, and a bolt of lightning hit the monster.
What did you say? That funny little mark? Lightning flying about the place? Here I was hoping he'd turn out nice and ordinary, but it seems his grandfather was right all along. Well, I've been putting this off for long enough now. You and me need to have a little talk. Here, this belongs to you. Grandfather asked me to give you it once you'd come of age and climbed the tour. The truth is, there's something I've been keeping a secret all these years, something I've never told another soul in the village. It's... how can I put this now? Well, he said you're... you're the reincarnation of the Luminary.
What?
Oh, don't ask me what the old fool meant, dear. I haven't got the foggiest. All I know is that your grandfather said you had a special destiny and that there was something you had to do. He said that when you came of age, you were to head north to the capital, up there in Heliodor, and show that necklace thingy to the king. He seemed to think that if you did that, all would become clear. Clear as mud, I shouldn't wonder. Anyway, the long and short of it is that if you want to find out what this is all about, you'll have to leave Cobblestone and head over to Heliod.
Crikey.
Well, I can't stop you leaving, I'm sure, but you won't be marching on an empty stomach. Come on, dinner.
Can't sleep either, eh? You remember this tree, don't you? I got my scarf stuck in it all those years ago. There I was, crying like mad, and there you were, running round trying to help me get it down. Some things never change, eh? You know, I always imagined we'd spend our whole lives right here in Cobblestone. That's why I was so surprised by what your mum said today. All that stuff about you being the Luminary, that reincarnation thing. I remember remember the story my granddad told me. Once upon a time, long, long ago, the world was terrorized by a horrible monster. But then, the Luminary appeared and saved the day. When it was all over, the Luminary turned into a star. And he's been watching over us from up in the heavens ever since. That's his star, right there. How can you be the Luminary too? I just don't get it. I know. That's what you're going to Heliodor to find out. I understand, really I do. Listen, we should both be getting back. Everyone will be wondering where we've got to. Goodbye, old friend.
Well, just look at you. You don't scrub up too bad, you know. You won't forget him, will you? He was a fine, upstanding man, the pride of the village. You could do worse than try to be like him. Well, however you turn out, I'm sure you'll find a way to overcome whatever lies ahead. A mother knows these things. Oh, by the way, I've popped a little money I'd saved for a rainy day in your pack. Don't spend it all at once. Why don't you visit the village shop before you head off to Heliodor? You'll need some supplies for your big adventure. But don't take too long. The whole village is turning out to wave you off.
One day you're just a little boy, the next you're getting ready to leave us. I only wish your grandfather could see what a fine young man you've become. To think, it's been so many years already since old Chalky found you floating in... I mean, since he brought you to Cobblestone. We never thought there was anything out of the ordinary about you. And now suddenly there's all this talk of luminaries, of all things. You know who the luminary was, of course. A legendary hero who saved the world from a terrible darkness. We're supposed to believe that you're him reincarnated? I don't doubt old Chalky, of course, but it is a little hard to swallow, I must say. Oh, when you meet the King of Heliodor, put in a good word for old Cobblestone, won't you, eh? If he finds out this is the village where the luminary was raised, that might be something in it for us.
You are terrible. Trust you to be thinking about what you can get out of it.
Oh, no, I'm only joking, of course. The very thought. Anyway, where was I? Ah, yes. Now, the fate that awaits you may well be one beyond anything we simple country folk can imagine. But you must allow us to offer what little assistance we can. And may this magnificent steed, the pride of Cobblestone, find Heliodor easily enough. Just head north out of the village and follow your nose.
You travel safely now. Oh, you're such a good boy, such a good boy.
With you. It will keep you safe. I heard there are lots of monsters where you're going. Be sure to keep it close, won't you? I don't know what's in store for you out there, but wherever you go and whoever... Take care, and remember, we'll be waiting for you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Clem. It can be risky heading into the great outdoors if you aren't familiar with the basics of See the remains of that fire over there? Well, when you spy one of those, it means you can set up camp and rest your weary bones. To settle down for the night, just go up to the fire and examine it. You'll soon be enjoying a well-earned break. What's that? You're worried about being attacked by monsters while you sleep? That statue over there is chock full of holy powers that'll keep the beasties at bay for as long as you need. And that's not all. You can pray to it to be cured of poison and all kinds of other things. Think of it as a mini church. Anyway, enough of my yammering. Why don't you take a closer look at all this camping kit for yourself? You'll need to get used to what campsites look like and how to find them. After all, it's like my old dad always said, keen campers can continue on where others can't. Well, that's all from me. If you have any camping-related queries, feel free to ask. I'm here all the time. I wouldn't want to be anywhere else.